And by the way, like, it's an important conversation. Parents grew up in an era where a degree was safe, but companies, guys, watch the world. The biggest companies in the world every day are stopping requiring college degrees. It's just not as valuable.
And the problem is, most people build their self-esteem around something stupid. So most people build their self-esteem around being right, being good, being smart, being worthy, and they see all of those as permanent traits. The single most important part in learning to be honest with yourself is to accept that you must have self-esteem. And the problem is, most people build their self-esteem around something stupid. So most people build their self-esteem around being right, being good, being smart, being worthy, and they see all of those as permanent traits. And so anything that challenges them being smart, which is my big one, oh God, even to this day, if I really want to get into a bad place, I'll just go hang around people that are just legitimately smarter than me and then focus on how cool being smart is. Now, I can be around them when I value myself for being the learner, but the second I let myself slip into just wanting to be cool for being smart, then being around those people is like getting kicked in the face. It sucks, man. And so I went through this phase in my life that I call the king of remedial jobs phase. And I wanted, so this is post film school, post like realizing that I don't have talent. I just need to be smart. I just need to build myself back up by being smart. And so I would apply for jobs. Like I sold video games retail, and I sold insurance door to door. I did anything that I could where I knew that the person interviewing me at some point during the interview was going to say, "Are you applying for this job? Like, you're too smart for this." And be like, "I'm right where I need to be," which is crazy and sad, but absolutely true. And so I did that for a couple years. And in that phase, I just didn't want my intelligence to be challenged. So flash forward now, I'm working with these two entrepreneurs. They hire me as a copywriter. I'm in an entrepreneurial environment for the first time. And they're clearly smarter than me. That isn't even up for debate. And I'm arguing with them for this idea because I needed to win. I couldn't take another time where it's like, they're smarter than me. So I was like, all right, I'm gonna win on this idea. And somewhere in the argument, I realized I was wrong. And there was a voice in my head screaming, "You're wrong, dude. You are wrong. You know you're wrong. Shut up. Like, stop pushing for this. What are you doing?" And I kept going, and I finally like whittled them down, and they finally just gave up. And so they said, "Yep, we'll do it your way. Fine, whatever." And right then and there, it's the one time in my life that was truly a lightning rod moment where my life can be divided before and after. And that moment was realizing that I was telling everybody that I wanted to get rich, but the way I was acting was like I just wanted to feel smart. And I thought, hey, no judgment, I'm totally cool. Whichever it is, like, we can craft the life where that would be wonderful. So if what you really want is to just be smart and to feel smart all the time, you have to quit. You've got to get out of this environment because they make you feel stupid all the time. And that's not a great place to be. Feeling badly about yourself all the time for any reason, even if it's self-inflicted, it's not a bad scenario or it's not a good scenario. You've got to get out of it. So I was like, okay, so that's option one. Get out of this scenario, go back to being the king of remedial jobs. Or if you actually want to get rich, start acting in accordance with it. Start making decisions based on that. And so I was like, okay, well, I'm going to have to give up my self-esteem. I'm going to have to like stop worrying about feeling good about myself. And I was like, ooh, that is clearly a losing proposition. There's no way to come in and feel horrible every day and think that I will have the energy to see this through. So I was like, God, what else could I do? And I was like, well, I guess I can build my self-esteem around something that is sort of impervious to being around people that are smarter than me. And what would that be? Being the learner. And I thought, okay, well, I could choose to do that. I could choose to build my self-esteem around being not right, but finding the right answer. Not being smart, but working hard to learn. And so that became just like the core of my existence. I decided in that moment, I'm going to start valuing myself for how rapidly I can admit when I'm wrong, how much I learn, how much time and energy I put into learning. And once I switched that and I switched my identity and my behaviors around to being the learner, then all of a sudden everything changed. And that's when I went on hockey stick growth, because all of a sudden, if we were arguing and I realized you were right, I'd be like, dude, he's right. You're totally right. I see it. oh my God, thank you so much. And so I started earning a reputation of, I never just backed into a corner. I never argued for something just because it was my idea. I was legitimately on the hunt to find the right answer. And so now I'm getting the internal feedback of, hey, you said that you were gonna always focus on being the learner, you're doing it, you said you'd always admit when you're wrong. And I would try to shorten that timeline down so I wasn't like taking an hour to finally admit it, or even 3 minutes, that I was trying to get to it. Like, dude, if I realize I was wrong, 3 seconds, 30 seconds max, like I'm, you know, just finally saying it. Look, you're totally right, I'm with you, yep, I see it. And then the world was like, whoa, working with this guy is awesome. He's not trying to take credit for other people's ideas. He will change on what he was saying in a heartbeat when you know, he fights for what he believes in, but the second you can convince him, he's convinced, and then he moves on. And it just became a really awesome environment.
Wow.
So that was hugely transformative, but it forces you to constantly be on the lookout for work.
I promise you here, out of every fucking person here, even if you sit here and your friend brought you and you didn't like me and you think I'm shit, nobody thinks less of themselves. Nobody thinks less of me in this room than me. I mean that. If I'm just unbelievably not high on my own supply. I appreciate the admiration. I understand what's happening with me. But I promise you, if you could read my insides on a piece of paper, I stand up here knowing I'm not shit. And tomorrow it can all go away unless I continue to execute. And I play on that edge every day. And I appreciate and I'm flattered. But I'm not fucking confused. Because 99% of people that I see that aren't even close to doing the shit that I'm doing, get one little headline or have a viral day or have one person with a blue check follow them and they think they're fucking special. If you think you're special, you fucking are finished. I mean, it's important to have confidence, but don't get delusional. It is absolutely your vulnerability. And let me remind everybody under 32 in this room, you have not faced a bad economy in your entire life. So you have not been punched in the face in a macro way yet. So whatever you think you are, you're playing in a fake fucking environment. You haven't done shit. You're in the minor leagues, boy. It's really simple. I genuinely wake up and think like, I suck. Nothing mattered that I did yesterday. Like, I might not be seeing, so I'm sharp. I'm like completely convinced that like, cool. But like, I said something recently that caught a lot of people's attention. When I say get quiet, I talk about get quiet from the haters. Don't listen to anybody, right? But I think the part that people didn't understand it is I meant the compliments too. All this love and admiration, you can't imagine how good it feels. But it's not penetrating my operating system. Like, you're literally gonna live 4 more lives, 5 more, like from the day you were born that you cannot fucking remember to right this second, you're about to do that 3 to 4 more times. Literally, your biggest advantage is timing. For all the great things that I have in my life, I would literally give it up, all of it. Just to be 25, I would give up for 17 years, I'd give up everything I have, because that's how valuable time is. And the far majority of this room has time as their asset, and every day, the number one asset they have, time, they give away by being impatient, mainly on the back of listening to society or their parents that they have to have their shit figured out at this age. The fact that people actually think at 18, 22, or 30, you have to have your shit figured out is fucking ridiculous. Let me promise you, all those parents and uncles and grandparents that push down your throat that you have to figure it out by now, they still haven't figured it the fuck out. So this fucking nonsense that you have to have it figured out at 18, 22, 30, you know how many people freak the fuck out at 30? How many people are 30 right now? That shit was crazy, right? Like, people lose their shit at 30. Like, meanwhile, they're a fucking kid. And so I'm unbelievably aware lately that one of the, you know, people are always like, why do you win? And I talk about my parents and not coming from anything. But the more that I live, I'm like, shit, the reason I really win is because I understand time. And listen, I know I can get hit by a bus or get terminally ill. I get it. Here's the problem. That's far more unlikely for the majority of us. The math works in your favor, and we are stunningly not patient. Because adversity is absolutely the foundation of success. The other thing I know is I have bad news. Nobody gives a fuck about your problems. And this is super important to understand. The second you actually understand that nobody actually gives a shit, the only people that listen to you complaining are your loser fucking friends. If you like complaining, like just take a step back. Look around the next time you're complaining about the government or you know, racial or feminine or, I had a guy sit in front of me the other day crying that his life was bad because he was a white male. Rich white male. I was like, oh shit, we've gone everywhere now. You're either on the offense or defense. I just want you to know something. One of the things that's been really on my mind is I think a lot of people think they're in the middle. They're like in a transit. You're only on the offense or the defense. And I've realized that I've been on the offense my whole life because I never felt in